Dear students, let's now discuss the concept of pressure. To understand the concept of pressure, let's have a look on a situation. Here you can see this is a wooden block on which we place a nail with its head in downward direction. And we try to hit the nail on its pointed end with the help of a hammer. And we can see even after hitting it several times, the nail will not penetrate into the wooden block because the flat head of the nail is placed on the wood. Now, if we invert the nail and we start hitting the head of nail with the help of hammer, you can see the nail will penetrate into the wood. Now, there is an important concept to understand here, why in the first situation or in the first case, nail was not penetrating into the wood. Whereas, by using the hammer, we were applying the same amount of force in the two cases. Now, here we can write down some important facts to understand this concept. The very first point is, when a force is applied on a surface, its effect is distributed over the surface. So, if surface is large, the effect will be distributed. Per unit area, the effect will be less. And here in succession, we can write, if area is less, the effect of applied force on body is more. Here you can see in the first case, the surface area which is in contact with the wood, that of nail, is due to the flat head of the nail. And as the area is large, the effect of the applied force on the surface of wood is less because it is distributed. And in the second case, when the pointed tip was in contact with the wood, the area of pointed tip is very small. That's why the effect of force is quite large and it was able to penetrate the wood. And here, the important point to understand is this effect of force on body is called pressure. Here, we can also write pressure as force per unit area on which the force is applied. If say a force is applied on a given area, if area is less, force per unit area will be more. That means we say the effect of force is more or the pressure is more.